This nigga, and I've been singing it all week because I had to learn it for two nights ago for the Farbringen in Binyanei Uma with Rav Ginsburg, and he had me learn this new nigga. This nigga, according to Chabad, is the Baal Shem Tov's nigga, and I didn't know it before. I'm sure some of you have heard it. It's a beautiful, beautiful nigga. It's a beautiful nigga. And we were just there, so Medjibush. So let's see if you can learn this one. I have to remember it though. How does it start? Yam bam ba ya na la ya, da da la 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 la, ah, da da la 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 la, ah la da la la la, yam bam ba yam bam ba, ah, da da yam bam ba yam bam ba. I lie, Level. Isn't this a Gavard Nigan?
Beautiful.
Anybody know this Nigan? What a Nigan. It was amazing. Did you hear it the other night, Neil? It was one of the first ones we sang the other night.
I wasn't there right at the beginning.
So okay. So Rav Gizra wanted to open up the whole night with this Nigan of the Baal Shem Tov. Okay, so now if you want to remember it really well, remember in a Nigan is always your kind of, it's not just singing a song, it's connecting to Shem Hashem. So remember, a Nigan is Yud Kei Vav Kei. How? A nigun that has three parts. So you sing the first part, then the second part, then the third part, then the second part again. Right? Yud ke vav ke. That's why Hasidim sing. They always go back to the second part. Yud ke vav. Hey, always back. So now try to sing it again, okay? Really, with much more kaya. Ay la 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 la.
I like, 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 I like,
Who's chazen this Shabbos? Shem, I heard you're chazen this Shabbos. You're gonna chadaydi, okay? Okay. No, don't worry. We'll get there. Okay, so we're almost, listen, we're almost really like, you know, real chassidim. This is there's nothing on the table to either drink or eat, so that's a little bit of a weird Yutes Kislev or Bichlal. So to gotta do that avodah for next time. I almost told you to go straight to Kaddish after Shmona Esrei today. Skip Tachnu, you don't say Tachnu today. I didn't, but until we switched to Nusach Svayed at least. And I can't just say, oh, I'll choose now to skip a Tachnu. It was like a big Musa. And Bichlal, Rav Eshel didn't go up to the Amma today because he's in Avedus and today's Yantiv, so there's something in the air. And I saw you with a hat on the other night, so I'm Bichlal, you know.
It was my Chabad fix.
We should all be Zeicha for a good Babich fix. So we're going to see something just to take this day, Yitzchak Kislev, into our hearts and realize that it's so much more than just if I feel like Chabad. It's so much bigger than that. It's so much bigger than that. But it's also that. It's also that. So as you pass these out, I'm asking for the following thing. I'm going to pass these out. I'm going to go in a circle round over here. And I want you each to say in mamish one word. Literally. Not a whole thesis here. Gedyanta, brother. Just in one word. When I say the word Alter Rebbe or Hadich, right? Tanya, Chabad. What's one word that comes to mind? Hershey, start with you. One
children.
Word. Children.
Kedusha.
Spirituality.
Fear, but that's because my father-in-law is a Chabadnik.
Let's stick to the one word thingy. No explanations. David.
Malchus.
You stole your word.
Yaniv.
Ari.
Legend.
That beautiful. Neil.
Rabba.
Kiva.
Dynasty.
Yes. The Gamma. Kobes.
Warmth.
Mamish. Binyamin.
Shark.
Sharp.
Khalif.
Khalif. Yeah. Nayach.
Kiruv.
Emes.
Anatomy.
It's like I'm dying to darshan out everything you're saying, but I'm like holding myself to my word. Yeah. What are you saying? No. Say. Yes?
Intellect.
Absolutely. Tov.
Serenity.
Malchut.
Mashiach. That's my word. Mashiach. Okay. Now, if what we just said drives, like if we said Chabad, like the Alter Rebbe, Hadich, and this is the answers we're getting, it means that, you understand, like if I asked you about another topic, none of you would probably be saying words that are very like, I mean, I could have guessed, not what each of you would say, but the Ruach of what it strikes in us is something that's larger than us. Mashu gadol meitano. You know, we could take everything we just said right now and plug in the word bittul. I'm bittul before children. Bittul before a dynasty. I'm bittul before those that are mekarving. I'm bittul in front of warmth, right? We could say whatever it is, but in other words, it's mashu shegadol me'aleinu. Something that's larger than life. Larger than us. Tell you the truth, for me, Yutes Kislev every year was always this concept of like, do I really buy into the whole, you know, Lubavitch thing? And then I realize that's not the Indian here. It's not the Indian at all. It's larger than that. It's about Malchus, it's about Mashiach, it's about something much bigger than any of us. And that's what I wanted to look into today, because today, just for those of you that don't know yet, two main things happened today. Actually, three main things. But one of them is not necessarily connected to Chabad, just if Avi Miller listens to this, he'll get nachas. Today's actually the Yortzeit of Rav Neria, Rav Moshe Tzvi Neria, the head of the Bnei Akiva Yeshivas in Eretz Yisrael. They're having a huge fundraiser today. Today is the Yortzeit of the Magid of Mizrich. Now, we were by the Magid last year in Anapoli. We were right there, buried next to his Talmud, the Rebbe Reb Zusha. As you know, the Magid was the successor of the Baal Shem Tov. I don't like the word successor. He was the next generation. Successors, there's no such thing as successor.
Continued.
Yeah, continued, yeah, the next. And it's also the day that the Alter Rebbe was released from prison. After being there for how long? How do we know that? Kanachon. Can I give the 53 chapters in the Tanya? The Alter Rebbe was there for 53 days. It was not the only time he was there. He was there another time as well in jail. But the one that specifically, that we speak about, is this one, right? He wasn't the only Rebbe that was in jail. His son was in jail too, the Mittler Rebbe, and the Friedeker Rebbe as well. The sixth Rebbe was also in jail. So what we're going to see today, we're going to get a glimpse, I think, into Yitzchak Kislev in a way that we could relate to, in a way that can give us a lot of koyach and chizuk to strengthen everything that we're doing. Shem and I were together the other night in Binyanei Uma. If any of you haven't been yet to what's going on there, all the words we said right now is happening in a certain room called the massive Sfarim Sale. Did you go inside, Neil? Kiruv, Malchus, Warmth, Dynasty, Children, everything we said right now. Well, I don't know if L'chaims are in there.
A little fear.
Fear, huh?
There was one room.
There was a room of L'chaim on the side.
Last night there was...
In the Sifriyatu? It's a real chagigah. There's a real aura of yantiv in the air. So you think, so it's a Chabad thing, so therefore it's like a bunch of Chabavit Svarim. Chaim Yudelman came home with a massive set of Likutei Maharan, okay? It's you understand what's going on there? There's the most beautiful new editions of the Me'ah Shilach, of the Ohev Yisrael, of the Radom, every Chassidus you ever heard of, and that you didn't hear of, it's all there. It's a day of they made it into a week of Yafutzu. And in Eretz Yisrael, the language is, now that they're calling it now, it's under the name Tzama. The concerts, the discs, the whole thing is called Tzama. There's a thirst for something. So yesterday, a social worker was on her way to go and meet with her Lubavitch, I don't know if you call them patients, but whatever it is, people that she had to attend to in Tzfat. It was the real strong ones there, right? The Chabatskas up there. And she asked me on the way there, like, what could she bring up that might be a little bit new and mira'anen it's fresh. So Boaz always tells me the same vort every year. Boaz Rizhitsky. Hashem should give him a lot of koyach. Ezat Hashem. And clarity. So Boaz said to me, he said, everyone wants to know, like, what is the whole chiddush of the Baal Shem Tov today, right? So he said, the Baal Shem Tov, when he met Mashiach up in the Heichal, up there, he said to the Baal Shem Tov, Eimasai ka simar, which means, when are you coming? And what did the Baal Shem Tov, what was the answer by Mashiach?
In your wellsprings.
Lech sheyafutzu meinasecha chutza. Do you ask people questions in a certain language and get answered in a different language? Because that's what happened over there. Mm-hmm. The Baal Shem asks Mashiach in Aramaic, chutz laretz. Mashiach answers him in Hebrew. Gewalt, huh?
It happens in my household.
Yeah. What an amazing thing that is, huh? What an amazing thing that is. Like, it's not stem. Now, in Lubavitch, they do diukim on every letter that happens in conversations, right? Everything. There are hundreds and hundreds of books written about every detail that happened regarding the Alter Rebbe's arrest, his time in there, his time out there, and every day since then, right? So our diuk is that we're saying the Shaila to Mashiach was in a non-Geuladika world, a non-Geuladika land. A Masai Ka Simar, when are you coming? And he could have answered him in Aramaic. He answers him in Hebrew. And where does it have to Yafutsu? And we see it here in Eretz Yisrael. I don't know, when I walked in there the other night, and then I played at this Fabringen. I don't even call it Fabringen, this Malchus Dika. I don't even know, right, Neil? It was just...
I don't know what it was, but it was nice.
It was just hundreds and hundreds of Eretz Yisrael children and their parents thirsting for whatever it was. Again, to not label it, whatever was going on over there.
Probably started with about 500 when I got there, but I think it hit about 1,000 at the peak.
Couldn't believe it. For me personally, I was in a completely different world. My Rebbe came, and he sat on the dais next to me, and then next to him was Rav Ginsburg. Rav Weinberger was there, so Bichlal. I don't know what's going on here.
Was he holding your hand?
It was
about
amazing.
10 minutes. Was that Weinberger?
That's Rav Weinberger.
The
yeah.
That came out.
Yeah. Yeah. I saw him earlier that day. We went together to pay Shiva Kol Beit Tzvi. And he asked me. He said, "What time is tonight?" I said, "Oh, it's like from 8 to like 12 to 15." So he said, "Okay, we're gonna go there now for the Sfarim sale, and maybe I'll see you later." So I thought, whatever, you know. And then couldn't believe it. So it was like a real. It's a tzama. It's a when you're really thirsty for something and you can't necessarily say what it is. Don't belittle what it is that you're thirsty for. Just keep on figuring out what that is. And that's what's going on in the world right now. It's been happening for a long time, and in Yetzer Kislev we celebrate again the emergence of thirst for something bigger. And if you think of any Chabadnik and any Shliach that ever played a role in your life, today is the day they get their koach from. It's this day. It's what's called Rosh Hashanah for Chassidus. Today is the day that they start learning Tanya from the beginning, Seder Yomi, every day. Today is the day that a lot of hachlatot, a lot of decisions are being made. And it all has to be done b'simcha, and with achrayus for Am Yisrael. This is the day of responsibility for Am Yisrael on a very big level as well. So it's Mamash a day for us as well, and we should be zochet to plug into it. So this is a little article, but it has some very important details about Yutes Kislev that I think can help us piece a lot of this puzzle together. Chag Geula, it's called, the day the festival of redemption, Yutes Kislev, is the day the Alter Rebbe was freed. Yom Shichro Shel Rabbeinu Shnei Yozal Miliadi Balatania Bal Shulchan Aruch Miaset Chasidus Chabad. Just so no one gets confused over here, he did not write the Shulchan Aruch. He wrote the Shulchan Aruch Harav. That's the Magid told him. You have a brain. You could take the Shulchan Aruch and you can write it in a more concise way. And that's what we have. We have it in the Shul as well. Shulchan Aruch Harav. That's the Balatania's Shulchan Aruch. From where? Mima Asaro Berusia Hatzarit. You know, we just came back from the Ukraine. It's a very different Ukraine, although nothing's changed on a Ruach level, but on a Lamaisa level, right? A lot has changed. We went in and went out, it was all give out, no problem. And we wore our tefillin, and we danced, and we sang, and we wore our kippahs, and tzitzis, on things unheard of. Not only like 200 years ago, unheard of 30, 40 years ago, but all the more so 200 years ago. Nahu kvar yoter mi-200 shana, it's already over 200 years, lo rak bekeilot chasidei Chabad, ela bechol tfutzas Yisrael. This Yom Yutes Kislev is not just amongst Lubavitchers, it's something in the whole world. Chasidim mechinim atzman likras ha-yom hazeh b'yisrakshus miyuchedes. Chasidim prepare themselves on this day with extra excitement. Lovshim bigdei Shabbos, umizkabtzim li-svaduyos chasidiyos, sheim shachas el toch shos ha-knaros sha-alayla. Do you realize that the Yutev Kislev festivities start already, like this year it starts already on like Tez Zayin Kislev, and it's going, Shoshana has hers tomorrow night, already Chaf Aleph Kislev. It's a whole, there's, you know, the Hachanas, then there's Yantiv, then there's Isru Chag, then there's, he's sticking a Cholamay that comes after. It's why? Because it's all me'ever la proportziot. It's not fixed, it's larger than time as well. מפליש גם יהודים מגזע חסידים שנצרחנו משמיעת תורה ומצוות מרגישים חובה לבוא לסוודת יוטס בקיסלב ולא במחסר בעקבות זאת לחי את תורה ומצוות מלאים. It's something very interesting. Even people that grew up Chassidish but left it at a certain point, they still, Yutes Kislev is still a chunk in their heart, and they always come back for Farbrengens. Used to see this back in the day in Kfar Chabad when the main Isvadus, when the main Farbrengen, and even the president of Israel, Zalman Shazar, used to come there. Menachem Begin used to go there. That's where the main attraction used to be before just Chabad spread everywhere. So what would happen was a lot of older Chassidim that were Chassidim when they were younger, and they left for whatever the reasons were. They Yutes Kislev still, you know, held a place in their heart, and they'd come back to the Farbrengens, and this date itself brought a lot of kiruv. Lamai, so Rabbeinu Azaken chazazot beruach kodesh. The Alter Rebbe saw this. He saw this happening. Now listen to this very interesting detail. Hayu chassidim sherotzu lichtov Megillat Yutes Kislev. They had a whole, like Megillah, you have Megillah Esther. So they prepared a whole Megillat Yutes Kislev with all the details, the whole story of it taking place. וכבר הכינו נוסח של מגילה כזאת. אולם רבינו הזקן לא קיבלה, he said, no, 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 no. This is not, we're not doing this. ואמר שסיפור המעשר וגאולה אינו צריך להיות כתוב במגילה. It doesn't need to be written in a Megillah. Why? משום שהוא יישאר חי לנצח בלב ישראל. This day doesn't need a Megillah to be reminded about. It'll be alive and pumping in the hearts of Am Yisrael forever. Very, very deep reason, huh? וכה אמר, this is what he said. זה היום יוקבע למועד תמידי בישראל. This day will be instituted and fixed as a eternal holiday in Am Yisrael. Now, interesting, he didn't say Chag Moed. What does Moed mean? Literally, Ohel Moed. What does it mean? Meeting, encounter. God bless you. So he uses the words, this day will be an eternal day of encountering. Not Stam. Of meeting. Of us meeting HaKadosh Baruch Hu, and of us meeting ourselves, and of us meeting the Torah. So that's just like, listen, if we're going to go on Lubavitch today, got to go diukim on every word the Alter Rebbe said and didn't say. So I think that's beautiful. It's a day of eternal meeting. Of what, David, what word did you say?
Encountering.
Of coming across, of getting to know the Ribbono Shelam, and getting to know ourselves. Asher bo yisgadal v'yisgadal shmei Rabba. That in this day, the name of Hashem will become great. V'yisoreru alfi levavos b'Yisrael b'tshuva v'avodah shebalev. And thousands of hearts of Am Yisrael will wake up in tshuva and in service of the heart. What's that? Avodah shebalev, tefillah and davening. Ki hamaisa, the story, chakuka belev Yisrael dileela, it's engraved in the heart of Am Yisrael that's above. Uksuva belev Yisrael diletata, and it's written in the heart of Am Yisrael down here. I don't want to get into that one too much. That's a big one. Okay. But now look, this is very, very deep. Rabbeinu HaZaken Amar, the Alter Rebbe says, Mi sheyismach besimcha, see, whoever is happy with my simcha, otzi'enu min hameitzar el hamerchav. I will take him out of the narrowness into the expansiveness. Nosach sheni, another version of what he said, min hageshem el haruach, from materialism to the spirituality. Doesn't mean rain over here, right? Nusach shlishi min hagehenom. Ah, now we're treading already on someone else's words. Whose nusach does this sound like? Reb Nachman's, I'm going to take you out of Gehenom. But so the third version is not so much accepted. I heard the first one quite often, okay? Yesh girsa acheres, there's a whole other version. Shelefi amar Rabbeinu HaZaken, mi sheishtate v'yikach chelek besimchati, yizkeh lirot nachat miyotzei chalatzav. That whoever, it's beautiful, whoever takes a part in this simcha of Yutes Kislev, of my day, he'll merit seeing, having nachas from his offspring. So, however you look at these four versions, it's kedai to just have a little bit of simcha today. Because who doesn't want to get out of hell? Who doesn't want to go to the spirit? And who doesn't want to feel more expansiveness? And who doesn't want to have nachas from their children? So however we're holding it, it's kedai, right? Shichruro, now this gets very interesting now. Shichruro shel Rebbe ma'asaro hevi gal adir shel simcha bekerem chassidim. By the time the Alter Rebbe went into jail, I believe the year was 1798, okay? Either 1798 or 1799, I'm not sure. One of those 2 years. By then, what the Alter Rebbe established was massive. I shared on the trip on the bus that when Reb Nachman met the Alter Rebbe, so when he told his Chassidim, Tnu kavod l'sar ha'elef, give kavod to the minister of the thousands. And Reb Nachman's Chassidim were asking the Alter Rebbe, is it true you really have like thousands of Chassidim? Because there was no such thing like that back then. There was no such thing. It's 50, 60 years after the Baal Shem Tov to already have thousands of Chassidim by then, but he did. So the Simcha on this day was already massive back then, and it was a big, big Simcha. Imagine, they thought this is the continuation, the Baal Shem Tov, the Magid, and the Alter Rebbe. And the Alter Rebbe is in jail, and if he's going to be sentenced to death, which was very highly likely, there was no one that was close to being able to say they could continue. They thought this might be the end.
know, it's incredible that he kind of, so to speak, brought this on himself, because he could have chilled under Napoleon, and he didn't have to do this run. You know, and I don't know if Napoleon would have killed him, like, you know, put him in this type of position.
Well, what you're referring to is a little bit later in his life. This is before. This is before. You're talking, I mean, what you're speaking about is very much what will explain to us, like, Hadach. What's up with that? Why did he go there? This is not Napoleon. This is Mamish, the Russians. What's interesting is, think of it, like, it's amazing. No words are stam. Like, how do you say, like, what does Russia mean? Huh? Rasha. It's like very interesting. Dafka that.
No, but then even more so after experiencing the jail, to say no, I'm going back.
Oh, so then jail. Definitely, legamre. Like, however way you look at it, he could have taken the chill pill. He could have very much not have suffered. Is mesiris nefesh is the reason we're sitting here today like this. So there's a tremendous simcha when he came out of jail. By the way, do you know how he even, like, why he got in jail? Yeah, but who caused that to happen? A yid, yeah. It's not like a Russian found out about what he's doing.
They didn't put him because of the Misnagdim said because they put him in because he was sending money to Eretz Yisrael.
Right. No. I'm not saying the reasons why he was in jail. I'm saying who caused that there'll be a halshana. That's what I mean.
Right.
Rabbeinu was, now look what happens. There was such a simcha, okay? Now, if there's one thing about Lubavitch, about the tzaddikim, they have this inyan of being able to be reserved. Very reserved. I mean, when you're working with the moyach, with the intellect so much, and in complete harmony with the heart, you learn how to understand, how to have your mind be shaylet al halev, and not let the heart just dictate what it is. I'll give you an example. When the Rebbe and his wife made it to America, finally, during the war, okay? So who's the Rebbe married to? Who was the Rebbe married to? The Friedeker Rebbe's daughter, the sixth Rebbe's daughter. The Friedeker Rebbe was already in America. You want to hear something crazy? The Rebbe finally comes to America with his wife, and they're around the corner from the Friedeker Rebbe. The Friedeker Rebbe waited 3 days to meet with them. 3 days. Why? He needed to be that there could be some kind of in olam hazeh kli for such a simcha to take place. So he did 3 days hachanas to see his daughter and son-in-law. Okay. That just says it all.
Space too. Also, Yaakov Avinu waits 2 years to see his father once he comes back in Eretz
Yisrael. Yaakov and see to see Yitzchak.
To see
Yitzchak. Yeah. There's an Indian here, you know. Be like, wow, we just, you know. In Lubavi, it's there's this. I mean, a king has to be reserved. It's Malchus. So look what the Alter Rebbe says. Rabbeinu Azaken Chashash. We're in this paragraph, the second line. He Chashash. He had a suspicion. Shema Tisteha Simcha Leafikim Lo Chiyuvim. He was nervous that the Simcha the Hasidim had for his release would go to bad places, would end up being in bad places. Vekatav igeret hanikret katonti. And he wrote one of his letters, which was called katonti. It's the second igeret in the igros that are printed in the Tanya. I actually printed it in our booklet that we had in the Ukraine. We didn't, unfortunately, we didn't get a chance to learn it. But in this igeret, it's called katonti. Al shem ptichatav basuk shem Yaakov Avinu, katonti mikol chasidim mikol emes. Baltebe was released in the week of Parshat Vayishlach. He felt very much like Yaakov says in Parshat Vayishlach, Katonti, who am I from all the chesed that Hashem did to me? And that's how he opens up the Igeret that he sends this chasidim. Big and Yeshua, Baruch Shekivanta, because now he's going to continue to connect to Yaakov Avinu. Be'igeret zo kotev ha-rabi. Now this is the Alter Rebbe's words to his chasidim after the release. Bati mina modi'im moda'a rabba l'kvelus anshei shlomeinu anash. If you've ever heard that, the Rashi Tevas, Aleph Nun Shin, Anshei Shlomeinu, Breslev uses it also. Ah, Hume Anash, Hume Anash, he's one of us. Hume Anash, like there was a guy collecting money the other week, and then Tzvi walked in, and he whispered, he's like, Hume Anash, Hume Anash. He's one of us, he's Anshei Shlomeinu, right? People of our peace, Hume Anash. But you'll see it a lot, like in Svarim, those three words. So this is a general statement, an important thing I want to say to all our people. Al ribui hachasadim asher higdil Hashem la'asos imanu, for how much chesed Hashem did with us. What should we do? Le'echoz b'midosav shel Yaakov. Let's grab onto the midos of Yaakov. What does that mean, the midos of Yaakov? Levilti rum levava me'acheyem. Don't start walking around like this with your heart upwards, higher than your brothers. Velo la'archiv aleihem peh, o lisrok aleihem chas v'shalom. Now's not the time to go and bash the misnagdim or other groups, whatever it is. Because he was nervous that the simcha over the release of the Alter Rebbe from prison would lead to gaiva. Look at us. We are winning. Even if it's true, like we're winning. Dida notzach. He says, not chas nish, chas v'shon. You shouldn't walk around like that. Has mi laskir behazhara nora'a. Shh. Quiet. And I'm warning you. Rak lehashpil ru. What should you do now with the simcha? He says, use the simcha to activate shiflut. What's shiflut? Humility. Humbleness. Use the simcha to activate midot you wouldn't generally use naturally through simcha. It's very interesting, huh?
You see this in the Pesach story.
How so?
After we crossed over and you see all the mitzvahs get slaughtered, there's no celebration on the other side. And that's against the enemies, like clear.
So Kal v'chomer on Yidden.
Other Yidden.
Rak leha, so he says, use this simcha lehashpil rucham belibam bemidas emes liyakov. Use this simcha to be mashpil your ruach and your heart in the midah of emes liyakov. Mipnei kol adam benemichus ruach. Like Yaakov Avinu, in front of every person that he came in contact with, there was a shiflut and nemichut ruach. Nemichut ruach doesn't mean low in spirit. It just means not haughty. Okay? Doesn't mean, God forbid, you know, nemichut ruach, you think could mean like nebuch, or nechon, like, or, what?
Lowly.
Lowly, yeah. It means the opposite of gaiva. That's what we're speaking about. Umane rach meshiv chima v'ruach nike, v'kulei hai v'ulai yiten Hashem b'lev acheim kamayim apanim. And when you act like this, then maybe Hashem will, Bezrat Hashem, bless those hearts that see hearts that are shofel to be turned on and touched by this spirit of holy simcha through the shiflut. Yeah.
What do you make from this? He's comparing it his yitziyah from being incarcerated to Yaakov Avinu. Yaakov Avinu is about to meet with Esav, his brother. He's scared. And here he's comparing that moment of yitziyah to a moment where Yaakov Avinu is afraid of.
I could go pretty far and guess, but Esav was his brother.
Yeah.
He's talking about meeting other Yidden right now.
It's funny. So his worry was not being incarcerated by Levon.
Never.
His worry is when he's leaving.
That's the next piece. It's exactly that. And that's a very good point you're bringing up. His Indian, he knew these are all pawns. Right? The people that jailed him. Remember the story about the Friedrich Rebbe in jail when they put a gun to his head and the guy saw that he's not scared at all? Remember what the Friedrich Rebbe said to him?
One God, many lives.
One gun, two worlds. Like you think this, right? He's saying, you're talking to someone that does not believe that this is it. Yeah. I believe there's something else. You think you're having the gun, but you only have one life. Mm-hmm. I have no gun, but two worlds. Mm-hmm. So the whole mitziyut of the Alter Rebbe in jail and what he understood from that whole thing, he realized that that had nothing to do at all. They were stamp pawns. Now that yid that also tattled, that rattled on him, he's also a pawn, but him is who I have to still work with. Because he knew already back then, you know, Lubavitcher, like I had a friend that went to, he went to the Rebbe, and his impression was when he walked into the Fabring and he realized, this is a man, he wouldn't ask this from anybody, but if anyone tried to hurt this man up there, there'd be like 500,000 people that would take a bullet for one person. It's not even a question. No? Any chassid in the world? So this the Alter Rebbe saw that this Indian was already like in the DNA of the Lubavitchers, right? Of Chabadskas. So he thought that maybe perhaps this simcha would lead to this like koyach of that wouldn't bring more kiruv. That would bring anything but that. So he directs the simcha in a very clear and fashioned manner and makes sure it's used in the right way. Let's finish this. Ulam ha-simcha mil'a et ha-levavot. However, the simcha filled the hearts. V'garma l'chassidim liot b'itpa'alut atzuma migodel ha-chesed she'era lehem ha-kadosh baruch hu. It caused chassidim to be in a great, tremendous state of hitpa'alut. What does hitpa'alut mean? Wonder would be with an aleph.
Like a
rising. Yeah, po'al, activation. Pe'ilut, pe'ula. You never went to Bnei Akiva, any of you? Pe'ulot, havdil. That's not exactly an activation of the soul. It's more like just taking sticks and writing the name of somebody on it. But anyway, ayu chasidim shenagu litpalel mituch tzeakot neraot ad shelo yu yicholim litpalel bet ha-knesset v'ayu yotzim el michutz la'ir mitpalelim sham. That's what used to be. Back in the day, they would, the chassidim, the way they would daven would just be crazy, crazy screaming, right? And until like they had to stop davening a shul, leave the city and daven somewhere else. Kavur shana biyutet bekislev taf kuf samech. So yeah, so that means taf kuf samech is 1799. So that means, yes, a year later, that means the story was in 1798. So a year later, in 1799, Amar Rabbeinu Azaken Maimer Chassidus, the Rebbe, Alter Rebbe said a Maimer, Ubo Romem et Avodat HaMoach, where he elevated the Avoda of the mind, Vehishpil Ubitel et HaItpa'alut Shel Avodat HaLev, Kshehi LaAtzma. And what did he do that year? He lowered the importance, or here he says, Bitel. He kind of nullified the Avoda, where it was just about the heart, which would cause you to start screaming uncontrollably. He did that a year after his ma'asar. Now, what they say here, this is the Friedrich Rebbe, Zaita hora'at sha'a. That was just for that year he had to do that. Do you understand what they're saying over here? What was he saying? He's saying, look, we need to get focused. And the focus right now needs to be that it's the mayach. I mean, look at the Tanya, right? So it was just a hora'at sha'a. That means it was just for its time. כדי להוריד את החסידים ממרומי ההתפעלות לעבודת השם מסודרת ויציבה. To establish seder. The thing that really, really attracted me personally to the world of the Alter Rebbe really, really was seder. The seder. That I know it's the Baal Shem Tov, so I know this is fire and it's light and it's burning and it's simcha. And it's dveikus and everything, but I want the or should have a kli, and in Lubavitch, it's, you know, for whatever you want to say, there's a seder. If you walk into the Eichel Menachem Lubavitch bookstore, just Lubavitch bookstore, and you walk in there, and you don't know much about Yiddishkeit, you'd think that in here is every sefer on Yiddishkeit. It's not. It's all Lubavitch svarim. There is a yam of chokhmah. There's a sea of Torah in there. So, this is what the Alter Rebbe wanted to establish. Seder, yitzivut, stability. And he did it more than anybody else ever did it since the Baal Shem Tov. Without a shadow of a doubt, because look at today. Look at the world today. And I think those of us that were in Hadash just 5 days ago, right? I think we saw that when we got there. No? You get there, you walk into this, you're in this, you're on this horrible, dark, I talked about it on Shabbos a little bit, this, you never went to Hadash, right? You're always in, you're on a road that I'm sure if we just like had to like think about it for a second, we'd start getting carsick, like nauseous again, because the roads are zva'a atomit, mamish, horrible, and it's long. It's 3-4 hours on a horrible, horrible road, and there's nothing to see. Not just because it was really dark. Even if there was light out there, there's nothing to see out there. And you get to the town of Hadash, and it's disgusting. And then you go down a little mountain. Welcome to Six Flags. It's like this whole... Mamish, it's like... What? Right? Seder. Seder. It's a cover. There's a tzaddik. Our tzaddik's buried here. We're mesudar here. We're going to make this place mesudar. Malchus. warmth. This is a dynasty. We're taking care of business here. This was established by really that first year of the Alter Rebbe coming out of jail. He set up shop. And that shop is still being presented in the world, to the world, in a manner which shows you, yes, come, have a l'chaim, be besimcha, but let's learn how to become mensches. Okay. Let's finish. This is the last paragraph. K'me'a shana achar kach, b'shnat taf reish samach beiz. What's taf reish samach beiz? 1902. Shiger kvot kdushas admor harashab. By the way, in Lubavitch, these Rashi Tevas show up all the time. Let's just go over it for our sake. Chaf and Kuf, Kvod Kedushat, Admor. Does anyone know what Admor stands for? Adoneinu, Moreinu, Verabeinu. That's what Admor stands for. Kvod Kedushat, Admor, Harashab. Who was the Rashab?
The fifth
Rebbe, the father of the Friedrich Rebbe. The Rashab sent an igeret likrat chag ha-geula yutet kislev uba katav al ha-chag. He sent out a letter to all the chassidim back then, and this is what was written in it. Uba katav ha-chag asher pada b'shalom nafshenu, the holiday where the shalom of our souls was redeemed. Ve'or v'chiyus nafshenu nitan lanu, and the light and the chiyus, the livelihood of our nefesh was given to us. Hayom azeh hu rosh hashana ledach. What does dach stand for? Divrei Elokim chayim. Words of the live of the live God. God that's alive. Divrei Elokim chayim. Dalet aleph chaf chet is also very much always written in all the Bavitch Asfarim. I just want us to be familiar with this language, okay? Dalet aleph ches, dach. And the Rashab says, Asher hinchilanu avasim hakdoshim. Our fathers gave this to us. And what is this? Vehihi Torah Baal Shem Tov. And this is the Torah of the Baal Shem Tov. This is just a cute thing to end with. Kshigia geret leVilna, when this letter in 1902 that the Rashab wrote reached Vilna. Vilna is not exactly, you know, Hasidish headquarters, right? But there were Hasidim there. So they gathered together, hitasfu chasidei ha'ir nidvadut gdola bevet ha'kneset apatov. I'm not sure what the shul was. They gathered together. Because, you know, whenever the Rebbe would send you know what chasidim would do when they knew that a letter came in from one of the Rebbes? You think they just read it? They went to the mikveh first. They davened their hearts out. They learned. They went into his hisbeinenus. They gathered together and we had a l'chaim, and then together would look and read it. Read the words. You know, back in the day when the Rebbe was before social media. So what would happen? How would the Rebbe would give a mimer, if I bring in, right? A sicha. So you have the guys that are, if it's on Shabbos, they would write it after Shabbos. But if it was there, they would type it up, and the faxes would start be sent, or the telegrams would be sent out. And in different countries all over the world, they would gather together, do the same thing. Today, we have all of this in the palm of our hands. Mamish. That's missing from today. I mean, a Rebbe, a living Rebbe, like, is also the Indian, like, that's what I saw by Rav Ginsburg, is that he's never gonna, there's no such thing as the next Rebbe in Lubavitch, and he's never gonna start his own chassidus. But he's the closest, I've never seen anything closer to a feeling of being in the presence of something that's not me'olam hazeh, not from this world. It's not from this world. So if something that's not from this world is sending something to this world, you treat it with utmost covet and respect. So this igeret the Rashab sent reached Vilna, so the chassidim get together in the shul. And in that same city, I'll just say this outside, you don't have to translate everywhere, in the same city there was a Rav that lived there, that he was a Rav that had he was very makil, he was very lenient in certain areas in halacha, and what his thing was that he used to make fun of chassidim. So who else was in there? Reb Chaim Eiser Grudzinski. Okay, Reb Chaim Eiser. Reb Chaim Eiser wasn't a chassid, but Reb Chaim Eiser was a gadol shem Yisrael, a gadol shem gadolim. Hopefully we'll do a whole inyan about his life as well. So, in the Mishnah it says, b'mishnah niske, so this Rav said, you know, in the Mishnah it says there's four Rosh Hashanahs, right? Rosh Hashanah for the kings, Rosh Hashanah for the plant, right? There's four different Rosh Hashanahs. And he made fun, he's like, haha, and the Hasidim suddenly have the chutzpah. They added a fifth Rosh Hashanah, because they call it Rosh Hashanah and Hasidus. So what does Reb Chaim Eisner say? He say, at least they add. At least they're into adding. You're into taking away, taking off things, right? But I want to get back to something Yeshua said before, and we'll end with this. And I want to sing that niggun again that we sang in the beginning. So I wanted to get mamish kavua in us. You know what was so clear to the Alter Rebbe? And this is what he was trying to tell his Hasidim that year. You know, the Lubavitch refers to the Alter Rebbe's life as before Petersburg and after Petersburg, meaning before he was in there and after he was in there. Truth is, Reb Nachman lived his life like that as well. Before Eretz Yisrael and after Eretz Yisrael. The Alter Rebbe did not want Hasidim not only to think less of other Yidden, but he also understood that the Tsar, right, the Rush, the those that put him inside there, was for him to do a birur on his avoda. Meaning, in jail is when he had this interaction with the Baal Shem and the Magid, trying to know, to understand, should I continue doing what I'm doing, which was the dissemination of the secrets of the Torah, secrets of the world. Because whenever you do that, you know there's going to be heavy things happening to you. Remember, all the tzaddikim that started spreading light in massive ways, they always sense their life's about to end because it's not as a punishment. It's just that it's such a massive thing. It's not for this world. And I don't know how many of you saw that picture of the Alter Rebbe in jail that they put up, they painted when we were in Hadash last week, right? So you see he's looking up, but you don't see who he's looking at to, because that's the Baal Shem Tov and the Magid in his vision that came to him. And what was the answer the Baal Shem Tov gave him? Not only should you not stop, adrabah, spread it out like it's no one's business. He understood that they're just pawns for a birur, a clarification of what the avoda ruchni should be. And that's what he wanted Chassidim to always keep in mind. That anything that you're going through, the tests you're going through, it might seem like it's them, right? Look what they're doing. But it's always an opportunity to get clarification on our avodah ruchanit. And that's the Rosh Hashanah of Chassidus. That's in a nutshell for us today to connect to this very auspicious day. I want to highly recommend to everyone, not just because for our souls, but to give kavod to Rav Shlomi, who's doing it for Brengen tonight at 8 or 8:30? 8:30 at the Tzur Chagai?
It's 8 o'clock.
Which means 9, but whatever.
Okay.
And whoever is not busy, to try to make it out there, and your wives, to give, not just give kavod to Shoshana, but give kavod to themselves.
Tonight's
Merim. I wanna push more Shoshana's thing for men and women.
No, just tonight.
That's what I'm saying. Tomorrow is only women, and it's someone from our kehila, so definitely our wives should go and be at that Farbringen tomorrow night and keep the Farbringen going all week, Bezrat Hashem. Okay, let's start that again from the beginning, last time. I like that. בשמחה, בשמחה, בשמחה.